Is the mind identical to the brain? Well, in 1848, a man named Phineas Gage survived the most unlikely accident. A premature explosion sent an iron rod directly through his skull and brain. Though he miraculously survived, those who knew him claimed that he was no longer Gage. So, if his personality changed, does that mean personality is part of the brain? This story is one of the most incredible stories I have ever heard, and it is indeed true, but there's one detail that is very often misrepresented, and it's not what you'd expect. Within philosophy of mind, the story of Phineas Gage is sometimes used as an argument against any dualistic theory, such as Descartes. Descartes claimed that the brain and mind are distinct substances. But if Gage's personality was altered by the accident, and if the mind were separate from the brain, then we wouldn't expect any changes in his personality, would we? Oh, by the way, much of inspiration for this episode is taken from this book by Ian Ravenscroft, Philosophy of Mind. In contrast to Descartes' theory, there is the identity theory, which simply states that the mind and brain are the same thing. The mind is identical to the brain, hence the name, identity theory. The identity theory itself is quite old. Even Thomas Hobbes in the 17th century seemed to support a version of it. It's also a very straightforward theory. It simply asserts that every mental state is a brain state. Importantly, though, it does not claim that for every brain state there is a corresponding mental state. The Australian philosopher J.J.C. Smart articulated this theory more precisely in this article, Sensations and Brain Processes. He argued that the relationship between mind and brain is like that of between lightning and electrical discharge. Lightning simply is a form of electrical discharge. They're the same thing. When I say that a sensation is a brain process, or that lightning is an electrical discharge, I am using is in the sense of strict identity, just as in the, in this case, necessary proposition, 7 is identical with the smallest prime number greater than 5. To fully understand this theory, we need to understand the distinction between types and tokens. Here we have two tokens of the type dog. Every individual dog is a token of the larger type or class of dogs. To elaborate, this is Lewis Carroll, the author of Alice in Wonderland, a token of the type author. But this is also Charles Dodgson, the man behind the pseudonym. So he too is part of the type author. But the important point here is that Lewis Carroll and Charles Dodgson are token identical. They are the same individual. If I would have invited both Charles Dodgson and Lewis Carroll to a tea party, only one man would have appeared, right? But we can also establish type identities, identities between classes. For instance, the class of authors is identical to the class professional writers. They refer to the same type, generally. Now, let's get back to the human mind. Within the human body, we have what is called C fibers, nerve fibers associated with transmitting pain signals. When these fire, pain is usually recognized within the subject. Now, for the type of pain, there is a corresponding, indeed identical, type of C fibers firing. Pain is a complex phenomenon, influenced by many factors. But for simplicity's sake, throughout the rest of this video, let's just imagine that C fibers firing is the only thing that does the whole pain job, so to say. It seems as though that we cannot have C fibers firing without pain. This gives us good reason to think that pain just is C fibers firing. One of the strongest arguments in favor of the identity theory is neuroscience, which shows a strong correlation between mental states and brain states. So it seems reasonable to believe that the mind and brain is the same thing. And it seems as though that the case of Phineas Gage that we talked about in the beginning supports this, doesn't it? But the problem with the story of Gage is that his supposed personality change was overly exaggerated by people who didn't really know him. So maybe the identity theory is flawed. How can mental states be identical to brain states if a metal rod can pass through the brain without fundamentally altering personality? I'm not sure. Maybe Gage was just simply lucky and the rod missed any parts of the brain that is crucial to personality. But there are additional challenges here. Probably the biggest issue here is consciousness. The identity theory claims that the mind is identical to the brain, but it lacks any explanation for why some brain states are conscious while others aren't. What's the difference between conscious and unconscious C fibers firing, for instance? Additionally, it seems to be in conflict with Leibniz's law of identity. Leibniz's law states that if two things are identical, then everything that is true of one must also be true of the other. For simplicity, let's return to pain. If pain is token identical to C fibers firing, then everything true of pain must also be true of C fibers firing. But that's simply not accurate. For instance, C fibers surprisingly have frequency, while pain does not. Or does your pain have a frequency? I think not, right? So it seems as though Leibniz's law is broken here. And we only really need to find one difference to conclude that these are two different things. Also, pain has the property of hurting, while C fibers firing does not. So they couldn't possibly be the same. But these objections seem more related to the problem of being conscious of pain. Maybe pain is C fibers firing, it's just that consciousness makes it feel a certain way. But still, the identity theory lacks an explanation for consciousness, so that doesn't fully resolve the issue. There's another major problem for the identity theory. If the identity theory claims that there is a type identity between pain and C fibers firing, then what about creatures without C fibers? If we meet an alien, it likely wouldn't have C fibers, yet it might still be able to feel pain. But if the identity theory is correct, then pain is C fibers firing. So the alien would never feel pain, which seems unlikely. This is known as the problem of multiple realization. There is an ingenious solution to this problem, though called functionalism, but that's a topic for the next episode. So if that sounds interesting, make sure to subscribe and I'll catch you then.